Good morning, Kathy. Hi, I'm Dory. I wanted to show you a few pictures of the house on Cobblestone so that you could see the front of it, because those aren't in the MLS. And I'll also show you some of the pictures of the neighborhood surrounding. So here we go. Here's the house. It's a territorial style. It's in the area of Northwest Fountain Hills, which is pretty close to Picatinny, the house that we first talked about. It's been updated since 2008. The folks bought it as a fix and flip. And one thing about this area is it is very close to the McDowell Mountains. Zoom in, you can see what type of a view you'd have. Got some nice landscaping on the lot, some desert vegetation. Beautiful ocotillo plant. We get the house unlocked. We'll take a look inside and you can see a little bit more. Okay, here we are inside that beautiful wood door. And as I mentioned, this is a home that's been recently redecorated, and they've done, I think, a wonderful job. Here in the living room, you have a nice big space for a very large screen TV, as they have here on one wall. Slider doors and a big glass wall out to a beautifully landscaped backyard. In the corner, you have a fireplace. And there's a gas insert inside the fireplace. There is not gas in this neighborhood, so that's going to be a propane fireplace, but nonetheless, it's easy to turn on and enjoy. As is normal in a lot of Fountain Hills homes, you've got a little bit of a few stairs throughout the house just to take up the grade of our beautiful hillsides, but of course that's what gives you the great views. And then also off of their living room, you have what would be a den or fourth bedroom, because actually this house does have quite a few bedrooms. They've chosen some great colors, a little bit of a contemporary motif. The window coverings are all in great shape, and some beautiful wood floors. They've also chosen what I believe is a porcelain tile, and it's all throughout the house along with the wood floors. There are very few carpeted areas, but this porcelain actually has a little bit of a sheen to it in some areas, so that it looks organic and earthy and yet a little bit sophisticated. Good quality floor coverings. I'm going here now into the master suite. You can tell that they've got plenty of room for some great furniture. I don't know what their likelihood is of selling the home furnished. We can find that out if you're interested. I love what they've done in the master bath. They've taken what was probably a small space originally and made it entirely functional and beautiful. You can see that they've chosen some great architectural elements like this light fixture, a farmhouse sink in the master. They've gone with a concrete top on that vanity, but with a little bit of a slump block or a split face edge. And all throughout the house, I believe I'm looking at cherry cabinetry, good quality cherry cabinetry with great poles. Got plenty of spaces for displaying art or knickknacks. Back in this area, what they've done is they basically opened up what would be the closet area with some beautiful cabinetry. Woman's a shoe freak, which is right up my alley. I don't know about you. Some additional countertop space. And then a nicely organized closet, lots of mirrors. And then back over here, good quality plumbing fixtures. A shower that they've done a beautiful job on with the tile patterns and stone patterns, a little bit of glass block, and a rain head shower along with a regular shower head. Kathy, this is for your husband as a way of apology because I've introduced you to a house over your price range, but the garage is a three-car garage with a lot of nice storage and outdoor refrigerator space and also a water softener. I like what they've done downstairs. There's a little separate wing where they've taken advantage of some available closet space with nice storage cabinets. In their guest bath, again, the beautiful tile patterns, good quality fixtures, a beautiful vessel sink. And here they've created a little bit of a guest area that used to be two completely separate bedrooms. And they opened up the wall, as you can see, with just an opening. It could be entirely closed in again, but it does make a nice guest suite. Room for a good sized bed, some great views out the windows, and a little TV area for guests or just for the family that lives here. Then we go down another few steps to that beautiful kitchen I showed you. They've chosen Electrolux stainless steel appliances. I love it when a microwave is at a reachable height. I never understand putting them up above so that everybody has to pull hot things down over their head. Full length cooktop hood. They've placed an insert oven below a ceramic cooktop. That's a 5-burner cooktop. The granite in here is stunning. They've chosen a black and dark colored granite with a lot of texture, and then they put a suede finish on it. You'll just have to see that in person. Again, a lot of nice cabinetry spaces, nice big drawers with pulls on them. I love nice big deep drawers that you can fit lots of things in. Hand slides, and then over here a great big sink with a commercial faucet, and looks like also a pot filler. Of course, this can be moved around onto the counter for that type of usage. Okay, as I mentioned, you've got some great mountain views here. I'm trying to get those for you. This is from a very large window that they built into the kitchen dining area so that you get those mountain views and really opens up the area. And then they've created a good sized dining space that can be either formal or informal, and that's the nice thing about it. You don't have to have two separate dining spaces. You can entertain or just enjoy it for the two of you in this space. There's a door out to the patio. Again, the patio does the same thing as the house. It takes up grade in a couple different areas, which makes for some interesting lounge areas. The backyard is fairly private, nicely landscaped around it. I'm sorry, there's some high light that may our view.
So, I hope that helps you understand this house a little bit better, and I look forward to meeting you in a couple weeks, and we'll take a look at this one and some others and see what works for you. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.